In 2019, grassroots donors gave roughly $1 billion to Democratic candidates and progressive groups through the online fundraising organization ActBlue.
On December 31st alone, the group brought in $20 million. So joining us to discuss the historic haul, how they're looking for 2020, Outreach Director for ActBlue, Patrick Frank. Patrick, he joins us now via Skype. It's great to see you, man. How are you?
I'm good. Thanks so much for having me.
Yeah, absolutely. So, Patrick, your platform has kind of been the answer to the Republicans. I think there's this win red. So how have you seen the evolution of ActBlue through the Democratic primary as the primary way for people to give money? And what are some interesting insights you can give us about the people who are giving money to Democratic candidates?
Yeah, no, I appreciate that question. First and foremost, it's just been an incredible year. The numbers speak for themselves. We saw over 1 billion donations come through the platform in 2019. $1 billion come through the platform in 2019 from over 6 million donors. And one of the really shocking numbers is that 3 million of those donors came to our platform for the first time. So you're seeing really an influx of new folks, which is very exciting.
Mm-hmm. And what are the numbers, compare those numbers to previous years. What's the kind of growth that you've seen on the platform?
Well, 6 million donors is definitely our biggest year ever. Over the course of, the whole of ActBlue, we've raised billions of dollars, but to see just 6 million folks in 1 year is by far a record.
And one non-election year, too. I mean, there were some elections across the country, but by and large, not. So this was an even bigger year than with the midterms, which also was a historic number for you all as well.
It was, and one of the really impressive numbers is that of those 3 million new donors, 40% of them have given more than once on the platform in 2019. So folks aren't just joining the democratic process through giving, but they're staying as well, which is really inspiring to see.
So Patrick, can you give us some of the demographic breakdown? I had seen before some ActBlue data that was dissected and looked at by occupation and which candidates those are going to. Do you have any of that, or can you go into some of the trends that you're seeing?
I think those stories are best told by the campaigns themselves, just because every list is different. But what we see is a broad swath of America in our donor base. And so, the jobs that make up America are the jobs that make up our donors.
That's interesting.
What do you think has sparked this uptick in grassroots fundraising? I mean, it's a fairly new phenomenon for ordinary people to see giving money to candidates as a part of their sort of democratic responsibility. So what do you ascribe that uptick to?
I think campaigns have done a great job of inviting people into that process. What we've seen is that campaigns that are fueled by small dollar donors have higher ceilings and can raise really impressive amounts of money and can sustain that. We believe that the general election nominee is going to need at least 50% of their money to come from small dollar donors. And so I think Democrats up and down the ticket from city council all the way to president have seen what ActBlue has done and have seen what small dollar donors have become on the left and want to be part of that movement.
Mm-hmm. So, Patrick, one interesting thing I'm curious about is how are the candidates marketing their donations? Do you know if a lot of the ActBlue donations come via like email or social media, and how much of it comes to their online game? Can you talk about that?
I think that's very dependent on the campaign itself. And so each campaign is going to look a little bit different. It's fair to say email is still the way that most people donate. We say here at ActBlue, email is queen. And that remains true. But one of the great things about online giving is that it can happen in a moment. To come back to some of the stats, in 2019, we saw 50% of all donations happen on mobile devices. And so you're seeing folks able to give whenever and wherever they are. And I think that definitely just changes some of the rhythm.
Yeah, it certainly does.
What does it mean for the Democratic Party that so much of the money now comes from the grassroots versus this like very small layer of elite, perennial donors that made up the donor class previously?
Well, I think it's great. And, you know, as sort of a general rule, I think the more people you can invite into your democracy, the better a democracy you have. And so, you know, when we see these levels of engagement, when you see 6 million donors give in a year, when you see over 500,000 contributions on December 31st alone for $20 million,
wow.
You're seeing folks that feel like they have power in their political system and have agency, and that's really inspiring to see.
Yeah, it certainly is. Thank you so much for joining us, Patrick. Really appreciate your analysis.
Thanks so much for having me. I appreciate
it. All right, we'll have more Rising for you right after this.